What's up, guys? Welcome to Mad About Cake. I'm your host, Joshua John Russell, and this week the Halloween episodes continue. I'm gonna build a five-tiered black cake with black buttercream, finished with black crackled fondant and some gold accents. Ooh, a ghost! You guys are gonna put a ghost there, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, let's do it! Okay, to get started, wait, Brandon, you don't have anything else superimposed around me, do you?
No way.
Okay, awesome. So I'm gonna break down this petal pan. I actually baked this with black cocoa powder, so it's gonna be really dark, and I made the buttercream with it, so the entire cake will be black, and then we'll finish it with black fondant. This gives a sort of like that Oreo kind of taste. You could mix it with regular cocoa powder just to get a darker powder, or a darker color. I actually just used full black cocoa powder. It's gonna be super dark. New shape!
What would you call that shape?
It's a petal pan. See? It's like a flower. Which seems like a happy pan, but I baked black cake in it. Well, the rest of the tiers are gonna be round. It'll be super dramatic on the bottom.
Joshua, you're really goth, man.
I'm the opposite of goth, actually. I'm like the white boy next door, that's what I am. Who sometimes wears mascara? I'm just kidding, I don't. Only on Tuesdays. Look how dark that is. All right, we're gonna cut this guy in half. All right, I'm gonna leave those guys together. This one, because it's so big, I have on the final presentation board. We'll just build it on top of here. No one's gonna try this new garbage cake? We did black cake on Cosmic Love.
That was quite the mittful, Nate.
A mitt like a taste, not a palmful.
Jake's so gothic.
All of a sudden, I just wanna listen to The Cure.
Hey, I love The Cure.
See, you're so gothic.
You're so gothic!
That's not gothic, is it?
Josh is goth.
Can't they just be a good band? I'm gonna clean up my crumbs and I'm gonna fill this with black buttercream. All right, we're gonna fill our cake, but because it's a weird shape, I'm actually not gonna trim this. So we're gonna fill it and crumb coat it at the same time with black buttercream. By the way, if you wanna see how I made the black buttercream, it's in the description box below or up there in the eye. And while you're down there, hit subscribe. You can really see the difference. The way when you bake this stuff, it gets super, super black. And then when it's just incorporated into something, it's like more of a really dark brown. This is cocoa, so it's a real thing. It's not like food coloring. So your guests will eat this and their mouth won't turn black because it's a real thing. And it actually tastes really good. It kind of tastes like Oreo.
If everybody's mouth turned black, that'd be like so goth.
Joshua, you'd love that. You're goth.
No, I'm not goth at all. Can't I make something gothic without being gothic? I don't even know what that means.
That defeatist attitude is very goth.
Shut off. You guys are all fired. Leave the camera. You're not leaving. So we're gonna slide our next layer on. Let's line them up. So to get the definition in the crease here, I'm gonna just take my spatula. This is not a spatula, my scraper. Put it up in there and then just pull away in opposite directions. Keeps that crease. All right, I'm gonna get them in the cooler and then we'll do the final coat. Now we're gonna cover our petal pan with black fondant, and I'm actually gonna do a crackle technique with this, but I have to roll it out a little bit first. Cornstarch.
Snow!
Winter is not coming.
I'm not a snow! Fresh snow. Yay!
Snow!
By the way, you guys have been posting some really awesome Halloween cakes. Keep them coming. Show me what you got for Halloween. Take a picture and post it on Instagram and Facebook with the hashtag cakeslayer or hashtag manaboutcake. I love looking at cake pictures. That feels about good. So roll it out to this point, and then we're gonna take sugar sheets. This is the sheet that you put through your edible printer, and I just airbrushed it like this charcoal gray color. But I'm actually gonna cut off this outside edge so we don't have a seam. All right, so we're tearing all of our little sheets into pieces, and we're gonna just decoupage this thing together.
Did you just say a bad word?
Decoupage isn't a bad word.
Okay.
All right, so we're gonna moisten the fondant where we're gonna place our pieces. Do one like here. Maybe we'll overlap it a little bit. Okay, now we're gonna roll this out. put it over our cake. That's kind of cool, huh? My cake is covered, now I'm gonna airbrush it black so the whole thing is super dark. Okay, now my cake is airbrushed and now we're gonna stack them all together with bubble tea straws. Now I'm gonna use some edible lacquer to make her super shiny. I'm gonna pipe a dramatic color around two of the tiers, the two solid black tiers. I'm doing this with royal icing that is dyed a gold color, and the reason why is because normally I would paint my white royal gold, but because it's against a black cake, if I miss a spot, the white is gonna really, really show up. Hey, if you guys like gothic cakes, I have a friend named Sonia McLean who has a tutorial on how to make black lace. She has great gothic sort of style. We'll put an excerpt from her tutorial in the eye or in the description box below. Now we're gonna make some molded decorations for the tiers that I didn't pipe on. I'm gonna do this with a little bit of gum paste. It's in the same color, that gold color. So when we go to paint them, if we miss a spot, it's not as easily visible. So this is the mold here. It's a silicone mold. So we're basically gonna roll this out and press in, and then we're gonna use this and the little sharp edge here to cut the rest of it away, and then we'll pull it out of the mold. This mold is actually clear, so you could turn around the other side and make sure you don't have any bubbles or make sure you've gotten every little bit of it, which I'll level it off this mold. Okay, I feel like that's pretty good. And now we're gonna roll across, and the sharp little edges are gonna cut it away, so you can already see it here. Come on, guy. You're on camera. Let's do it, see?
That freaks me out.
Are you freaked out?
It's just gross.
Why? Brennan's totally freaked out by that. Sometimes art is gross, and then it's beautiful. I don't think this is gross, though. I don't know where you're getting gross from. Because it looks like skin color?
No, look up trypophobia.
Oh, is that the fear of like lots of little holes?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. People had that reaction during the octopus cake. I apologize, but sometimes art is weird. All right, so we'll take our pieces out of the middle here, save those for another mold. So I'm just taking my fingers and pushing in on the paste to make sure we don't have any little hairy pieces. All right, and then we'll pull it out. You go upside down, and you want to pull it very, very tight this way, all the way back. You can use a little paintbrush to make sure none of the areas are sticking. See, Brandon? Freaked out still? You should see his face. That's pretty. Wait till I paint it gold. It's just in a weird color. And then we're gonna make a second decoration, which is like this fun swag pattern, but we're gonna use the largest one here. And this one's similar, but we're actually gonna just push it down into the mold, and then we'll cut the excess away. All right, so we're all pushed in. I'm just gonna take my knife here, and cut away the excess.
Can you use your big knife next time?
You've been hanging out with I, Justine, have you?
Hey, yeah, I, Justine uses giant knives for everything. I got this tip from her.
She got it from Crocodile Dundee.
I'll do the same thing. Take my paste and pull it away from the edge, and we'll pop this guy out.
Oh, there it is.
So now I'm gonna make a ton of these and we'll glue them to our cake and we'll finish everything with gold. All right, all my molds are cut out and now I'm gonna glue them on with piping gel. Now, what's this music I use here? For the final touch, we're gonna add some gold to our mold and piping. My favorite part, gold! Ooh, no, nothing.
Josh, but this cake isn't actually looking very goth at all.
It's not goth, it's gothic. Like a cathedral, like design, like an era. Gothic?
Brandon, you knew that, right?
What, you didn't know?
I told you, you didn't know? I thought
you thought it was like the pop culture thing? Like, no, it's
gonna be all Marilyn Manson.
Brandon.
Okay, I'm not just the only dummy here.
Did you all think that?
Yeah.
All right, I admit it.
No, it's for like a beautiful gothic. Like, think about a cathedral.
Yeah, I get it now.
Gargoyles and stuff. Okay.
Sorry for making fun of you the whole episode.
I know, right? I was wondering, I didn't understand that part at all. Our gothic wedding cake is complete, and I think she turned out super duper majestic. Hey, I want to get to know you guys. So in the description box below, I put together this little question and answer thingy so I can get to know who you are. Keep posting your Halloween pictures with hashtag manaboutcake or hashtag cakeslayer, because I love looking at cake pictures. Next week, the Halloween shenanigans continue. We're making creepy eyeball flowers. It's going to be awesome. We're so goth.
Joshua, in 10, 9,
that's
eight.
A lot. Let's.
Okay, to here, right?
Before you go too much further, can you take the bag off?
Oh, yeah. Just tuck that away for later when I'm sad.